Because in North Korea, gay is not a concept. If you don't know the concept of happiness, how do you know what that is, right? Exactly the same thing. The regime purposefully removed these concepts in North Koreans' minds, like the gay, freedom, individual liberty, human rights. But in North Korea, unless the marriage is challenging the ideology of the party, the regime doesn't grant divorce. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Yeonmi Park. I'm a North Korean defector, human rights activist. Now, in this very tough time that we are in during this pandemic, I thought we all needed some heartwarming, hopeful story. And that is exactly the story that I'm going to share today. I just read this article on BBC about North Korea's first gay man who escaped because he knew something was wrong. I mean, nothing wrong, but he thought the country told him that something was wrong since he couldn't find women attractive. After his defection, finally, at the end of his now he's over 60, he found the love of his life. Can you guess where he found his love of life? In America, in the USA. You know, in North Korea, we call America as the land of wolves, land of, you know, the cold-blooded monsters. And in this country, he found love. And this is like, it was so hopeful that like, you never know where life takes you to. And that's why you might be your girlfriend or boyfriend might be in North Korea right now. And there's more reason why we need to free this country. So to tell his story from the beginning, Mr. Zhang, he was born in Cheongjin, the border town of North Korea. And of course, everybody in North Korea have to get married, so he got married. But the first night of his marriage, he had a really hard time even to hold his wife's hand. And then he told his brothers that, you know, I don't find women attractive. And then in North Korea, I thought, okay, something's wrong with your health. So let's go take you to the hospital. Because in North Korea, gay is not a concept. It's like right now, we don't know what the species in the other planets look like, right? If there is one or not, it's not in our concept how other, you know, foreign aliens living. Exactly the same thing in North Korea. There's no literally vocabulary in the dictionary saying gay, what this means. And this is so important for us to understand why language and having the word to understand is important. If you don't know the concept of happiness, how do you know what that is, right? Exactly the same thing. The regime purposefully removed these concepts in North Koreans' minds, like the gay, freedom, individual liberty, human rights. All of these concepts are gone. So people, when this happens to them, the first thing we think is like, oh, medically something is wrong with you. So they took him to the hospital and checked him there. And of course, nothing was wrong with him physically. And people still all think like something is wrong with you physically. In 1997, a long time ago, he decided to escape because if he wanted to get divorced from his wife because his wife wasn't happy with him. And obviously because she wasn't loved by her husband, she would be very unhappy. He thought, oh, this is a very talented woman that I need to set her free. But in North Korea, unless the marriage is challenging the ideology of the party, the regime doesn't grant divorce. It's impossible. It's very hard to get divorced. When I came to America, I heard like 50% would get divorced. Not in North Korea. So he wasn't able to get divorced from her. So she couldn't get remarried at all. And only way for him to let his wife free was escaping. So he escaped to South Korea. When he arrived in South Korea, of course, they investigate all the factors to make sure that we are not spies, and they ask our motivation, why we escaped. And he said, I escaped because I didn't find women attractive. And in 1997 in South Korea, they were still very uneducated about the sexuality. They literally sent him to hospital to get a health check up again. And obviously didn't find any problem in his health. So he was set free. And in his journey to be adjusting to South Korea, one day he he read a newspaper and he saw an article about an American man coming out. And he thought, oh, that's what I am. You know, this is me. This is what is going on with me. So he knew that he was gay by then, like in South Korea after almost 30 years old. Then he started going to gay bars in Seoul and he met this lovely man through the introduction. So after 3 months later, he really fell in love. And then the boyfriend told him, like, we need to, if we want to get married, we need to get a bigger place. So why don't you sell all your stuff and give all the money to me so I can buy you bigger stuff, bigger house. And you can see what, you know, that's a scam. This South Korean man was scamming North Korean defector, Mr. Zhang. So he sold his house, everything, and gave him like 81,000 worth of money in 1990, like around that time. And then, of course, he never heard from the man. So he was so completely heartbroken. It took a really long time to overcome. And this is another thing. A lot of North Koreans go to South Korea. And I talked about like before that North Korea do not accept the private property. So when we even switch houses, like selling houses in North Korea, there is no broker, there's no contract. Every deal is done verbally. You can get like think right now, how does it work, right? People don't follow their words. How do you follow them, call them accountable? But people are very adaptable. Somehow in North Korea, it works. Everything is done through words. There's no document saying this is your land, this is your property, none of that. So a lot of North Koreans go to South Korea and South Koreans verbally say, oh, if you give me all your money, I'm gonna give you like interest rate of 10% and pay you back in 2 months. And then they trust the world and give them all everything. And of course they cannot get claim it back because there's no evidence and no contract that they cannot really win in the court. So many defectors get scammed in South Korea. And of course he's one of them. After all that years and the passing, he rebuilt his life. And only thing that he was able to cope with was writing. So he's an author. He wrote a book. I cannot wait to pick up his book. He because after his escape, his relatives was punished. His 4 siblings died from starvation and parents died. So he still has so much trauma to deal with. However, during the lockdown, he got on an online dating app. And guess what he found? He found the American man. So South Korean American, a Korean American man whose name was Min Soo, found him on the dating app. And they met each other at the airport. And what Mr. Zhang says, like he saw Min Soo at the airport. And literally this American man wearing like flip flops and like wearing shorts. And you know, Americans like dress so like casually. And it really gave him like wrong impression. He thought like, oh, he doesn't take life seriously. But of course, after he got to know him deeply, they fell in love. So finally, he found the love of his life. And he's in the process of divorcing his wife, I mean, in South Korea formally, so he can be remarrying to him. This was something, it just really made me very hopeful, you know. Being born in North Korea as a gay man, I cannot even imagine when everybody's like looking at you, something is wrong with you medically, and or as if you're a crazy person, and not even knowing what your condition is. You cannot even imagine that, right? You're in pain and nobody knows what's wrong with you. And also I'm grateful that he is somebody, is a representation of those minority groups in North Korea. I'm sure by natural law, after I read so much about it, a lot of people can have a set tendency to like their own gender, right? This is a very being a human thing to do. So, you know, it really confirms that there are gay men, there are lesbians in North Korea. It's just not accepted by the regime, and the regime wouldn't allow us to be who we are as an individuals. So I really hope that, you know, I hope you guys found his life story inspiring and really hopeful like I did. And I will try my best to cover more stories from North Koreans who overcame so much and, you know, prevailed in their journey and found freedom and love. So So thank you guys for watching today's video. If you like this video, please hit that like button and subscribe to this channel. And I'm very grateful for my Patreons to support me to keep making these contents. Love you guys, and I will see you all next time. Bye.